more American aid for Britain. This time it's manpower, for a number of United States airmen have volunteered for service with the RAF, with Colonel Sweeney of Lafayette Escadrille fame in command of the Eagle Squadron, as it's called.
The idea for the organization of this squadron came from the Lafayette Flying Corps, which served with the French Army in the last war. That corps had a wonderful record. Besides many daring reconnaissances, bombings, photographing, one of its units, the Lafayette Escadrille, had 199 official victories. The men who have come over to form this squadron are all experienced pilots. They will be worthy of their forebears. When the squadron is thoroughly trained, it will go to the front with the RAF squadrons, and I hope and I'm sure that it will hold up to the traditions. Squadron Leader Taylor is to take command of the squadron.
The Eagle Squadron is now being formed and is being made up entirely of American pilots. Some of these pilots have already seen action in fighter squadrons of the Royal Air Force and have brought down several enemy aircraft. When we are fully organized and trained as a squadron, we hope to carry on in some measure the magnificent work of our British contemporaries in the Royal Air Force.
All these young Americans have come here at their own expense for the honor of fighting side by side with the Royal Air Force in wiping out the Nazi Luftwaffe from the skies. They're as keen as mustard on learning all our boys can teach them. And it won't be long before they're in action. Good luck and happy landings to the Eagle Squadron.
It's a sign of the times when an all-American unit trains in Britain to fight our battle in British machines. These men know, as so many of their countrymen know, that the Battle of Britain is also the battle of world freedom. Already experienced airmen, these Americans learn fast. It won't take them long to graduate from trainers to Spitfires.
The American Eagle Fighter Squadron has completed its training and now takes its place in the front line of the RAF defense of Britain. The majority of the pilots were civilian airmen in the States before the war, holding tickets as commercial and transport pilots, stunt flyers at air circuses, and crop dusters, the job of spraying farmland from the air. Now the lads of the Eagle Squadron are flying Hurricanes and Spitfires, and the OC at their station has a few words to say about the splendid work they're doing.
Since the formation of the Eagle Squadron, it has been carrying out extensive flying training as a unit, and therefore the pilots have not yet had an opportunity of meeting the enemy in combat. They certainly form a link between the peoples of America and Britain, and they are certainly doing their part in the immense effort which the American people are now putting up to help us win the war. The pilots of the Eagle Squadron have come from all parts of the Union to help us fight our battles. They are very good pilots, and I think we shall hear a lot of them in the future.
The Eagle Fighter Squadron was officially formed towards the end of last year. Though American air volunteers had fought in the battles of France and Britain, a number having given their lives in our cause. Now the Eagle Squadron is on the job, fully trained and equipped. Fighting Americans in Hurricane Fighters, helping Britain with all they've got.
In October last year, the first American Eagle Squadron was formed in this country. Meet some of the pilots, and their mascot, of the second squadron, now operating as a unit of the RAF Fighter Command. These Americans have already taken part in a number of sweeps over the Channel and in convoy patrol duties. Many of them were civilian pilots in the States, but wartime flying presented an opportunity which they couldn't resist. So they made tracks to the nearest recruiting center and enlisted in the ever-growing ranks of the American Eagles. It It is British policy to preserve the national entity of the airmen who are fighting with the RAF. They therefore function as separate squadrons within the framework of a fighting service which has grown to magnificent strength in the fiery furnace of war.
A second Eagle Squadron has now been formed as a unit of the RAF Fighter Command. All honor to these American boys who have come over to join in our battle. The squadron leader is British, and the squadron has already taken part in sweeps across the Channel and in patrol duties. The Eagle Squadrons are only further proof that America is with us all the way.
The three All-American Eagle Squadrons of the RAF, with their 84 fighter pilots, are transferred to the U.S. Army Air Force after 18 months of splendid service. Air Chief Marshal Sir Shorto Douglas bids them farewell, after which General Spatz extends his welcome.
I would have wished that on this my first opportunity of addressing the Eagle Squadrons together on one station, my words should have been other than words of farewell. We of Fighter Command deeply regret this parting. The U.S. Army Air Corps, their gain is very much the Royal Air Force's loss. The loss to the Luftwaffe will no doubt continue as before. You were the vanguard of that great host of your compatriots who are now helping us to make these islands a base from which to launch that great offensive which we all desire. Goodbye and thank you, Eagle Squadrons number 71, 121, and 133. And good hunting to you.
Men of the Eagle Squadron, I welcome you to the 8th Air Force. Before turning you over to your new commanding officer, General Hunter, I must express my appreciation for the contribution which the ranks of the Royal Air Force have with you contributed to build up your splendid organization.
It's with pleasure and pride I welcome you into the 8th Fighter Command of the United States Army Air Forces.